Howdy, I'm RK, and this is Game Endeavor. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make a Raycaster that will cast a defined number of collision detection rays in one of the four cardinal directions. This is useful for things such as checking ground collisions, moving platforms, player detection, and more. Let's go ahead and get started. I'll begin by creating a Node2D for the Raycaster. This scene will only consist of this node and its script. We're going to declare a few constants named up, down, left, and right, which will be vector 2s representing the direction's numerical value. For example, up will have an x value of 0 and a y value of negative 1. We're going to want a little breathing room for our raycast, so we'll create a variable named skin width and set it to 1. Raycasting will be inset by this much in the boundaries, so that we'll have at least some length to cast our array with. For example, if the player is flush with the ground. We're also going to create a buffer to store our raycasting results. This is so that we're not allocating an array every call to the raycast, and so that the parent of the raycaster isn't required to create a buffer of its own. However, we will include the option to do so because we may as well. And likewise, if you have no intention of using the buffer, then you may choose to not include it. We're going to create a variable to determine how many rays to cast. This is important because if the object you're raycasting from is too wide, then you may end up not detecting collisions, which could have some odd side effects depending on what you're using it for. We'll call this variable buffer size. It will be an exported integer with a setter called setBufferSize, and I will default mine to 3. We'll go ahead and create our setter method. It's simply going to take the value passed to it, ensure that it is greater than 2 by making a call to the max function, and then it'll resize the buffer. Then we'll create our ready method, which will make a call to our setter and pass it our buffer size. This is to initialize the variables, making sure that buffer size is set appropriately and that the array is resized. And now for the main event, the setup for this is going to be a little long-winded. It's a lot of variable declaration and generating info to use for the raycast. We'll create a method named raycast. It'll take the parameters direction, being which way the cast will be performed, rect, being a rectangle-shaped 2D, which we'll be using the extents from to determine where the raycast will originate from and how wide to cast it. Generally, you would pass this from a collider, such as your physics collision-shaped 2D. The next parameter is mask, being the collision mask that the raycast will check. Then exceptions, which is an array of collision objects to ignore. I will default to an empty array. Ray length, being how far to perform the raycast. I will use a value of 16. If you're using this for ground detection, I like to be a little generous with the length. It allows the jumping controls to feel tighter and more responsive. And finally, the buffer parameter, which we will use to store the results and return them back when we're finished. I will use a default value of self.buffer. The first thing we're going to do is to make a check to ensure that proper direction was given to the method. So we'll use OR operators on our four directions to see if the direction is any of them, then surrounding that in parentheses and inverting it with a NOT operator. If this is true, then return a value of 0. You could send back negative 1 if you want, just be careful when using this with the array. Then we'll get the direct space state from a call to getWorld2D, which we will then store in a variable named space state. We'll need this to perform the raycast later. And then we'll get the extents from our rect shape, and reduce it by a vector 2 containing skin width. This will shrink it on all sides, including the side perpendicular to our direction. Then we'll declare our count variable and set it to 0. We'll be iterating this whenever we have a successful collision. And for readability, we'll create a variable named breakCount and set it to the size of our buffer array. Then we'll declare a variable named cast2. This will be used to determine the distance that our arrays will extend to, relative to their origin. We'll set this to raylength plus skinwidth in parentheses and then multiply it by the direction. We're nearly done initializing our variables. We'll declare a variable named origin, which we'll be setting in our for loop. This will determine where each individual array originates from, and finally we'll create our spacing variable, which is the length of the area between the rays. We'll use an if statement here to check our direction. If it's up or down, then we need to base the spacing on the width of our shape. So we'll set spacings to extents.x times 2 divided by parentheses raycount minus 1 close parentheses. This will divide our area up evenly among the number of raycasts we will be performing. If the direction isn't up or down, then it must be left or right, so we'll use an else to do the exact same thing, but base it on the height instead. We're going to iterate through the number of arrays, so we'll create a for loop for I in range raycount, and then we need to determine the origin for the ray. This will start as one of the corners and then increment based on the spacing and our current iteration for the loop. So we'll use an if statement to check which direction we're casting our arrays in. If it's either up or down, then we'll set origin to a vector 2 with an x value of negative extents.x plus spacing times I, and a y value of extents.y. This will put the origin at the bottom left corner of our shape and increment it towards the right. And we will need another if statement to check if our direction is up. If it is, then we'll need to flip the y value to negative so that it starts on the top left. If it's neither up nor down, then it must be left or right, so we'll do a very similar thing except with reverse values. So we'll set origin to a vector 2 with an x value of extents.x and a y value of negative extents.y plus spacing times I. And if it's left, then we'll flip the x origin. Finally, we have all the information we need to cast our ray. So we'll declare a variable named result and set it to spaceState.intersectRay, giving it the values global position plus origin, global position plus origin plus cast 2, exceptions, and mask. If we have a result, then we'll set our buffer array of index count to our result, and then increment count. Whenever you're reading the data, don't iterate past count because it may contain old data for old Raycast. And finally, outside of our for loop, we'll return a dictionary of our values buffer and count, labeled respectively, so that we can easily access the info from these results. With this done, we can simply make a call to our Raycast from wherever we need it. And if you just want to check to see if a collision has occurred, then you can check to see if count is greater than 0. Or if you want to access the individual results, then you can enter a for loop of range count and use that to access the results of the array. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, then be sure to join the sub club and share this with your friends. It's the best way to help others find my channel. Next week, I'll be participating in Blackthorn Prod's Game Jam, so come join us as we spend a week developing a game. Given that it's October and that the jam is being hosted by Blackthorn Prod, I may make my first attempt at a spoopy game. Pop into my Discord if you would like to bounce some ideas around. There are links to that and my Twitter in the description. And until next time, y'all take it easy.